So, I was watching Twilight with my girlfriend the other day, and wait for it. There he is, my beautiful man, Carter Burwell. I've known for a while that Carter Burwell works frequently with the Coen brothers, especially with the beautiful 16 minutes of ambiance that is No Country for Old Men's score. Gorgeous. Well, for me, it was just a bit of a shock to see Burwell's name flash on the screen while watching Twilight. However, the man's a genius, and I can't deny his style is just so recognizable. Everything he composes is just so Carter Burwell, it pleases me to my core. You can almost tell when it's a Burwellian score, but for me, the exception is Fargo. Perhaps I need to pay more attention to the score past the beautiful reimagining of Greensleeves, but anyway. There are a few specific melodic ideas that Mr. Burwell uses, which tell me the score is his. That being said, I heard some familiar music notes in the Twilight score, which reminded me of one of his perhaps lesser applauded scores, The Founder. After recognizing the melody, I promptly listened to the entire score of The Founder, 32 songs, a hair over an hour long, and I immediately dropped the opening track San Bernardino into my playlist of film score pieces I love, along with various other entrancing songs that make me feel something. Then it hit me. Not only do I really love the film The Founder, but the score as well. Since this playlist I created is about songs that make me feel something, let me just quickly describe what the piece San Bernardino made me feel. The beginning reminds me of some sprawling landscape or location that's larger than life. Some barren liminal space acting as a transition from unknown to that which is known. Kind of like that scene in There Will Be Blood. Haunting and terrifying the first time I saw it. He's just crawling on his back through the desert while this freaky music plays in the background, enhancing the mood. Interestingly enough, while San Bernardino is the first track on the soundtrack album, it is actually the second piece of music presented in the film. The first piece being the Multi-Mixer Man, which doesn't really exemplify the movie and tone as well as San Bernardino, now to be referred to as San B, does. Mood, tone, triumph, melancholy, ideation, creation, evolution of musical ideas and sound from beginning to end of these tracks. The creation and matching of tone is just perfect. The emotions the score brings out in me, even as it stands alone from the film, is just astounding. I mean, if you can't tell, I'm going to be gushing frequently through this video, so just be prepared for that. But I also want to say before I go any further, it should go without saying, but this video is an editorial. It's not objective fact. In other words, it's my subjective opinion on a piece of art. I'm not here to change minds or persuade. And as I said before, I'm just here to gush over something that I love and I'm currently obsessed with. Most of my thoughts on the score will be about the score itself and how it fits into various parts of the film. Even though I have a lot to say about the movie itself in terms of its presentation and accuracy, I will not. When I discuss the emotionality and musicality of the score, keep in mind that I am by no means an expert. I think I took one film music course in college, and that's literally it. But okay, that's more than enough for a preamble, so let's just get going. Let's have a quick conversation about Carter Burwell and the director, John Lee Hancock. These two guys have worked together on four movies, the most recent one actually being The Founder, and I like to think that those three films that came before The Founder solidified a decent working relationship, and that relationship between these two guys created such a perfect soundtrack. Although I love Carter Burwell, and how could I not, he scored three Billboards, Fargo, an adaptation just to name a few, John Lee Hancock, for me, leaves a little bit to be desired. I'm sorry, Bubby, I'm not the biggest fan. I like some of your films. Not the little things, but a few. That's probably one of the okayest movies ever made. The Founder itself isn't perfect, as I mentioned before, but I believe it to be elevated by the score. There's some pre-existing songs that are played in the film, and I'm not really going to touch on those apart from one. That one song plays during a very poignant moment, so I feel it necessary to at least mention it. But we're going to save that for later. The story is of course based on true events with some embellishment for a more dramatic story, so here's a super quick rundown on the film's plot so you understand what I'm talking about later on. Traveling salesman Ray Kroc stumbles across a revolutionary restaurant formed by the McDonald's brothers Dick and Mac, who hire Kroc as head of franchising. As he is more disillusioned with his strict contract and low income, Ray Kroc forms his own realty company with the help of Harry Sonneborn to become the exclusive provider of land for McDonald's franchisees, and in turn, the McDonald's brothers become disillusioned enough to want Ray Kroc gone. The brothers receive $2.7 million from Kroc for the use of the McDonald's name. Opting out of the contract, the brothers can keep their original restaurant, but they must change the name, which leads to them going out of business and McDonald's becoming a fast food and real estate empire with Ray Kroc at the top. Wow. Beforehand, I mentioned a bunch of random nouns that I used as descriptors for the soundtrack, and these emotions and such apply to the score due to its partnership with the film. But I believe that it also stands on its own rather well, which adds to it. I listen to these tracks for enjoyment, my own personal pleasure during free moments and while I'm walking my dog. I like to look at the soundtrack like a bell curve, in terms of the mood, in addition to the way the songs build upon themselves. The tracks in the beginning usually start rather simply, as if an idea is being formed. Just a little, simple, melodic line starting out, which develops into something huge and full with instrumentation, much like the formation of an idea. It begins with a thought. And it turns into a full-fledged idea. During the first half of the soundtrack, there is some sadness to be found among the triumph, but I'll save the blue talk for a bit later. What I mainly want to talk about is Music for a Found Harmonium, the only pre-existing song from this film that I really feel like mentioning. In the film, the brothers are explaining to Ray how they came up with the idea for their operational system which makes fast food fast. This is the peak of the joyful mood, in my opinion. Epic success after years in the making for these two hard-working brothers. I mean, I'll admit, the moment in the film is a bit cheesy. But looking at this moment abstractly, as if we just know what the scene is about, and we aren't seeing it play out on screen, this song captures that type of moment perfectly. It embodies triumph. I know this is likely not Carter Burwell's contribution to the film, rather Hancock's, but it beautifully adds to an already exceptional score. Triumph and joy throughout most of the beginning, as the main character Ray Kroc is achieving what he wants through persistence. All of these new ideas come to Ray and develop into these companies and products and services. The soundtrack evolves as his ideas do, and there are awesome variations on what I call Ray's theme. That is until we get to the turning point of the film, almost exactly in the middle of the soundtrack. As we reach the track titled Wolf in the Hen House, the entire mood shifts. No more sounds of triumph, only this intense melancholy with major scales used sparingly, and a low tempo becoming more upfront and apparent. Acoustic guitars and pianos combine in the first half of the score to create a sense of melancholy amid the sounds of success for Ray, as he struggles to find footing and a place in the world. The melancholy shifts at the midpoint to favor the sadness of the brothers as they are losing control of their business and lives. In my eyes, this score plays like a tragedy, but only as one for those around our protagonist. Even the things that go wrong for him appear as minor inconveniences, and he takes them in stride. After the soundtrack flip, there's a bunch of deep instrumentation showing a sort of darker side to the story. Minimalist darkness and melancholy. For example, the song Franchise Realty Roadshow is the evil version of the track titled Franchise for America from the first half of the soundtrack. Franchise for America captures this patriotism, a patriotism of a young man willing to give his life for his country, as long as those values are objectively good within that country. The marching drum beat underneath is if the track is from a war movie about a soldier just trying to make it home. On the other hand, Franchise Realty Roadshow feels like a government claiming eminent domain and seizing a poor soul's home in the name of democracy. In the world of the film, Franchise for America occurs when Ray Kroc is trying to convince the McDonald's brothers to franchise their loan business. He is passionate and convincing while talking about values that make their restaurant great. When Franchise Realty Roadshow comes around, he has become greedy and powerful, and he wishes to dominate with all these franchises. It's compulsive, and it lacks any sort of honesty on the part of his character. Even Ray's theme shifts from beginning to end. The first and penultimate tracks are the same song, just with inverted moods. Sand B is the opening track, which is composed of a piano melody undercut with percussion, acoustic guitar, and strings. The piece Secret to Success, the penultimate song, has the same melody on piano at a much slower tempo, with similar instrumentation underneath minus the percussion. Droning strings highlight the intense emotional shift from beginning to end. I just find this to be exceptionally done. Now we get to the final track, number one. It shows that Ray has won, and he is at the top of the totem pole. Many people say that is lonely at the top, and that is exactly what the final track embodies. Loneliness. Like a person stranded in their own mind. It's a haunting final track that leaves me with such a sense of longing, as if I've lost something near and dear to me. Like all that I've accomplished has been reduced to nothing by a force of nature without a care in the world. The Founders soundtrack is one of my favorites as of recently, and I feel like I should think more on the subject of film scores. There are so many compelling scores out there that just need a little bit of attention and recognition. For some reason, this one just speaks to me, all thanks to Twilight and my love for Robert Pattinson. Give the soundtrack a listen. Maybe you won't feel the same way I do, but I sure hope it makes you feel something. This is a bit of an overlooked soundtrack in my personal opinion. I have no idea if people actually listen to it or not. And a lot of what I just said are thoughts that aren't grounded in any sort of theory or anything like that. I just like talking about things that I love. See ya.